Phytochemistry and glutathione is the talk of today's lecture. I am a phytochemist, because I am a phytochemist. My name is Alicja Zobel. I'm a professor of biochemistry at Trent University, Ontario. And as well, I have been for a long period of time of Secretary of Phytochemical Society of North America and a member of European Phytochemical Society. So let's say I know 100,000 of different compounds the plants produce for their own defense. And my role is to find out how we, as humans, can use these compounds for our own benefit. And how the glutathione comes into it? It is the most important antioxidant in the world. The molecule that is really unavailable for the pharmacologists. Glutathione is the master antioxidant, and every cell needs to synthesize it for own benefits, because even the vitamin C and vitamin E, as we think nowadays, are the antioxidants, are the molecules reduced back to usable form by glutathione. And I hope that later on in our life, as a scientist, we are going to develop the special test for localization of glutathione in our immune cells, as well as to form the special test for amount of glutathione that everybody has. The higher the level of glutathione, the healthier the body, because the healthier the cells. And I would like to have everybody to have the maximum of glutathione level in every cell of our body. Again, my suggestion is healthy cell, high level of reduced compounds in our body, and health of our body is going to be perfect. Of course, if we don't have some genetical diseases, but I'm assuming that it is genetics of ours is perfect and we need only the antioxidants, all scavengers of free radicals. These two words recently came to television and to radio too, and we can read in the newspapers about them. We don't care very much about the level of the glutathione. Why? Because it needs to have precursors in the cell, and from these precursors we synthesize glutathione. Glutathione is a tripeptide built of three amino acids: glycine, glutamic acid, and cysteine. The problem of cysteine is that it's rather rare amino acid in our diet. And we have to remember that our genes very often are switched on or off with the diet or compounds in the diet that can modulate their phenotypic reactivity. So the glutathione is synthesized inside the cell if we give precursors to this part, to every cell. And glutathione cannot penetrate the cells, so it is very well organized as the molecule of the most importance, detoxification in our body. Because every cell synthesizes the side products, the waste products, and they have to be removed from the cell. For instance, nitrogen, nitrogen oxide, very important oxidizing molecules and tiny molecules in our body. They are so tiny that they can penetrate even DNA, penetrate the nucleus, the membrane, double membrane of the nucleus, go into the chromatin, and where the DNA is nearby, oxidizes the DNA, and then we have mutations. But glutathione is the molecule that is reducing these free radicals and oxidizing molecules. So we have to synthesize them. And, of course, plants synthesize them, bacteria synthesize them. It is as DNA, the information molecule, the glutathione is detoxification molecule. We have to remember this. And I am talking about it for more than now 10 years and doing some research on that. Some of them published in Proceedings of National Science of USA. That's why I became the scientist of New York Academy of Science. And we as well can have several of the different compounds that are reduced by this glutathione. But again, I want to emphasize the penetration of the whole molecule is not possible through the plasma membrane, that is the membrane around the cell, because it doesn't have the carriers to go inside. So there is no active transport into the cell. But there is the active transport outside the cell. So such a molecule, when it becomes free radical itself, because it oxidizes itself, oxidized glutathione must be and is transported by the special carrier outside of the cell. And our body can get rid of it later on, and we are healthy. So glutathione is synthesized inside the cell, and how does it do? It needs to have cysteine, glutamic acid, and glycine, and we have to have the synthetase of glutathione. For the synthetase, we need selenium, because in the active groove of this molecule of the enzyme, there is selenium. And as you can imagine, some of my subject as well, of my research, is connected with minerals, as their role is very important. In this case, the role of selenium is with the synthetase and the reductase of this glutathione. So glutathione can be reduced again inside the cell if there is a reductase. Okay, so how many other antioxidants are in our body, how it is connected with this phytochemistry that, you know, is my subject of 25 years of work. It is because many of the molecules we eat and the molecules that later on are in our lymph, I am saying these are the juices around the cells, are the reducing agents, but in the same moment the reaction goes both ways. So the molecule becomes oxidized. It itself becomes the free radical. I wanted to emphasize how important it is, glutathione versus the vitamin C. As biochemist, I know that there are five oxygens in vitamin C. So it becomes itself very dangerous free radical when it is using our cells to protect. I want to emphasize this. Vitamin C can be very dangerous if there is no glutathione nearby in the cell. It is this glutathione that is really the master molecule for detoxification. It makes reusable vitamin C again, or vitamin E, or vitamin A. It is such a chain of the reactions in the cell. And what is very important that we need these molecules on the pathway, that we need them because it is smaller free radical is then becoming is electron transferring into the larger molecule and the largest molecule, and then at the end it is glutathione. So let's say we are nowadays listening to TV and we are talking about antioxidants such as flavonoids, and coumarins, saponins, glucosinolates. I know all these compounds. That is my 30 years of work. I know that when they have the special benzene ring that absorbs electrons from another molecule's free radicals nearby, they capture these electrons and so they don't go into the nucleus. That is a dangerous part, you know. If we don't want mutations to happen in our body, in our cell, we want the free radicals, because without them there wouldn't be any chemistry going on, there wouldn't be any life. But we don't want these electrons to be transformed and located in the nucleus. This is what the glutathione does. So I want today to point into smaller free radical is reduced by, let's say, alpha benzopyrene or gamma benzopyrene. Alpha benzopyrenes are the first molecules synthesized by plants for their own use that are built of benzene ring and pyrene ring, and because of that they are having capability to absorb electron, but they become free radical. But they are small, And then there are gamma benzopyrons that have additional benzene ring, so two benzene ring, one pyron ring, in the position gamma, the pyron ring, and these are flavonoids. So we heard them in TV as flavonoids, bioflavonoids, shouldn't be known, named bio, because these are biological molecules, so flavonoids is enough. As gamma benzopyrons are larger molecules than alpha, so electrons are transformed into the larger one. That means that they are more stable. They don't migrate. They are not so mobile inside the cytoplasm, and they stay in their place. At the very end, the molecules that are still even larger can be polyphenolic compounds. And that's why some of the gallotannins that are synthesized from the green tea are the ones that give us the molecules that are larger in size, and they can have capture these electrons. But if these are many of these electrons migrating, so that means that our cell is having very active physiological stage, the electrons could still escape from the molecules, from these reducing factors. So at the end, there is glutathione that lets them become again the captives of electrons. And I must say that we don't praise enough of this molecule. The people who appreciate it are the people from the doctors in emergency rooms. When you suddenly arrive and you are somehow poisoned, for instance, bitten by some poisonous insect, or you ate some poison, for instance, the mushroom, then you are injected with glutathione. That means that even the molecules that are toxic, but they are outside the cells, yet I'm talking about this, the lymph, I'm talking about the blood, then the glutathione does the wonderful job, catches them, and it catches like my hands as a sandwich. And here inside is this toxin caught by two molecules of reduced glutathione. It becomes then oxidized and thrown out of the cell. So I hope that we are going to make now a better and more available for the public cheap test for production of glutathione and measurement of amount of glutathione in our body. Again, if we have enough glutathione, reduced compounds from our diet, we can be healthy. And later on, I can talk next time about this 100,000 of different molecules plants produced in the phytochemical processes and we use for our health.